Hi guys, this is Teresa again here at Try Chanel 5, and I am coming at you again before I head off to the gym myself is for some more quick tips for 2012 and beyond for your body, soul, and mind. So let's get started on that, okay? So I have my notes here. Okay, so number one, you want to absolutely have no carbs evening time when you're eating your dinner. No carbs at all. You want to stay with your protein. If you don't eat meat or fish or chicken or anything like that, you can have your tofu. And you want to eat your vegetables, either steamed or baked, or, you know, any kind of way that you cook them up healthy. And always proportion size your meals, no matter what time of the day it is, morning, noon, or night. You want to make sure you always proportion your size, the amount of food that you're eating, no matter what. Okay? So, number two, you want to at least eat your food 2 hours before bedtime. It's always important. You always want to eat your food 2 hours before bedtime. You want to make sure that your food is digested well. And then you don't want to go to bed on a full stomach with all those, you know, calories and everything that's on your stomach. I don't know how it affects you, but I know how it affects me, and it's not good. Not at all. I'm tossing and turning, I have bad dreams. I just, you know, it just, and so on and so forth, it doesn't work out for me. So I have to at least eat my meals at least a couple of hours before I go to bed. Which brings me to number one, because that was number two. Okay, and it may sound kind of crazy, but you can build up to it. But I always do 200 crunches before I go to bed. At least 200 crunches. Because what it does, and this was stated by a professional trainer, is that not only is it good for your psyche and for your mind, but it's also good for your muscles to burn fat and to activate your abdominal muscles before you go to bed. And I've been doing it for a while now, and you know, it's actually work. I don't really have too much of a tummy here. So, it works for me, so I absolutely love it. And so that's what I wanted to do. I just wanted to bring you some quick tips, and then I'm just going to show also some moves as far as for, and which I also heard from a trainer, some, it's called booty lift tips. Just to kind of lift the derriere. Woo! Okay, so watch out for that, because it's coming right after this. Okay, so I hope those quick tips helped you, and you guys have a beautiful, beautiful weekend. Okay, I'm gonna do the little demonstration, and then I'm off to the gym to my cycling class. All right, you guys, love you. Have a blessed, blessed weekend. Bye. Okay guys, so here is the booty lifting tips. I'm going to give you three of them. Watch closely. I don't have anyone to pan up and down the camera, so I'm going to do the best I can, okay? Alright. Okay, so the first one I'm going to do is the deadlift. Alright. Let me show you. Let me back up. Oh, let me get my weights. Now, what I have here is 5-pound weights, right? You can use whatever weights you want. Whatever is comfortable to you. I would prefer to go a little heavier than this. A lot heavier. But this is just good for just a quick demonstration, okay? So what you want to do is place the weights in your hands to the side. You want to keep your knees soft. You don't want to bring them back. You don't want to just snap them back. You want to keep your knees soft. Keep your feet planted to the floor, and then you want to just bring the weights down, and you want to bring them back up, and tighten up your glute as you're coming up. Always remember to hold in your stomach and exhale as you come up, and blow out. Inhale as you go down. And blow out as you come up. And just spread your legs out. So let me do it from the side, front here. and then to this side here. Remember to always hold your stomach in. Helps to work your back and your core. Okay? So that is number one. Let's go to number two. And you want to do at least 15 to 25 of those, okay? Especially with that light weight. All right, so with the second one is the ballet lift, all right? Like your little ballet dancer. You don't have to do that. You can hold on to something or place your hands on your hip or whatever is a good balancing act for you. Place your leg back and you just want to do these. And you can touch the ground, whatever level that you feel like is comfortable for you. Always remember to hold your stomach in. And I'm exhaling as I'm bringing my leg up at the same time. And 15 to 25 of these as well. And then you want to switch to your other leg as well. 4, 5. So you can touch your foot to the ground, or you can just keep it up at level here. Okay, so that was number two. And number three is the reverse lunges. And you want to do 15 to 25 as well with those as well. So I'm going to come down and you want to just, and you can do the walking lunges too. But if you don't have the room or you just want to incorporate this with the walking lunge, you can. But this is just the lunge to go and down. Again, 15 to 24, 25 of these. And you want to hold in your core. And you want to take, you know, you want to make sure that you're breathing normally. And as you come up, make sure you squeeze the booty, okay? And you can also incorporate your weights too. Hold them in your hand here or down below here or up here or whatever it is that is comfortable for you, or no weights. And just hold your hands to your hips and just bring it up and then down. And then you can also do like little ones like this or just do this. And again, you can also incorporate that with the walking lunge. Okay? Okay? All right, guys, so I'm off to class and I'll see you guys next time. All right, guys. Bye.